one wonders what they would do if they saw a ghost.
Well, Nora thought she saw a ghost, but I didn't see anything.
Forget facts. Forget logic. Forget everything that seems real. Just trust. And believe.
Because this is all in your mind.
When I was around 11, I spent the night at my friend's house. It was awesome. We spent hours eating pizza and playing his new Xbox 360, until at some point, around 10 or 11, we heard his mom on the stairs. "It's time for bed, everyone," she said my friend's name. "Can you make sure everyone has a place to sleep?" He nodded and the four of us shuffled off down the hallway. At the time, I was really self-conscious about how I looked, so I insisted on staying in the spare room by myself. While the rest of my friends went out to the living room to watch cartoons, I closed the door and drifted off to sleep. I didn't sleep well that night. I kept having a recurring nightmare which wouldn't leave me alone. After one that was particularly vivid, I woke up sweating. I probably would have screamed if I could make any noise. In fact, not only could I not scream, I couldn't move at all. As I lay there, I couldn't help but notice the sound of footsteps near the door to the bedroom. I could have sworn I heard the door open and then shut. Then there was silence. My heart was pounding. Then the bed sheets started to rise. As I lay there, unable to move or make a sound, the sheets rose into the air just a few inches before falling back down. They shook, and then something slithered up from the side of the bed. I couldn't make out what it was, since it never broke from underneath the covers. It was the size of a full-grown man. It was then that I got a little strength back. I tried to yell for help, still no sound. I knew that I had to do something, so using what little strength I had, I rolled away from the shape and reached for anything I could use to fight this thing, whatever it was. My hand hit something leathery, so I grabbed it and pulled it back towards me. I rolled back over to face the shape in the bed next to me, but it was gone. As soon as I got my strength back, I looked around the room to see where that thing could have gone. There was nothing. In fact, I couldn't see any evidence that anything had ever been there. When I had enough strength to get up and move, I walked down the hallway towards where my friends were sleeping in the living room. They were all dead asleep. So I wandered back to the room and eventually fell asleep again myself. To this day, I don't know what happened to me that night. This story happened in 2018. I was living in Washington at the time with three friends of mine in a little town right off a state highway. I remember it was winter and the cold weather kept most of the people from working in the fields where they usually made their living. Since most of the people were at home when it was cold, there was hardly anyone out and about during the day. The town was deathly still, but my friends and I were busy working with a local church at the time, so we didn't notice the silence. Despite the cold and the quiet, I was happy and pretty relaxed most days, which is why the next experience is so strange. For those who are unfamiliar with sleep paralysis, it happens most often when you're stressed or upset. This wasn't the case this time. This happened late one evening. To be honest, I don't remember noticing the actual paralysis at first. Instead, the first thing I noticed was the silence. It felt to me like the dead silence of the cold outside air had found its way into our apartment somehow, and that if I tried to make any noise, the sound wouldn't make it past my lips. Then I heard something else. It was really quiet at first, like something was tapping on the window, only it wasn't. The sound was coming from the small portable air conditioner in the wall by the kitchen. I could see it from where I was sleeping in the main room. And as I watched, the sound seemed to grow louder and closer. In my mind, the only thing I could think of was that the sound was somehow trying to crawl its way through the air conditioning unit. I stared directly into the air conditioner grill as the sound became more and more clear. Tick, tick, tick. It was a hoarse, chilling voice, and it echoed through the room. I was sure the voice wasn't real, and I tried to get out of bed to check out what was actually going on. That's when it hit me. I couldn't move. I could do nothing but watch as the voice came closer and closer. At this point, the voice was so close, I could have sworn it was on the other side of the air conditioner grill. Then it showed up. Long, white claws reached out through the holes in the grate and ripped it open from the inside. The best way I could describe the thing that crawled out from the torn grate was a pale, white figure. Like the Demogorgon from Stranger Things. A huge, milky gray eye dominated its face. It seemed to look around from one corner of the room to the other, as if it was hunting for something. My strength was starting to return at this point, and again I reached for the only thing close enough for me to grab. It was a large leather Bible on the table next to me. As soon as my hand touched the cover, the thing was gone. There was no evidence that the air conditioner had ever been damaged at all. After the disappearing air conditioner demon I just saw, I decided to get up and get a glass of water from the kitchen to clear my head. I am not ready to outright say that the Bible has stopped every single case of sleep paralysis I've had, but I've kept a book of scripture on my nightstand ever since. After the thing in the air conditioner, I experienced a year of sweet, uninterrupted sleep. I had learned more about sleep paralysis since my last experience, so that might have helped the situation a little bit. After I moved home, I decided to go back to college. I spent the first 6 months of my college life hopping between my parents' house and my dorm room, until I finally settled into an apartment the summer after I started my sophomore year. It was quiet. All three of my roommates worked or were at school late, so I hardly ever saw them. Since I was alone most evenings, I spent my time watching YouTube or tapping away on my computer. One night, I watched a video called The Man Behind the Mirror, a creepy story about a ghost behind the walls of a house that was trying to steal a family's young child. You can probably guess how it ends. The family finds a body in the walls and all that. After the video, I turned out the lights and went to bed like any other night. My dreams were a lot more vivid than usual that night. I don't remember what I was dreaming of when this particular episode took place, but I remember waking up in a panic. Again, I couldn't move, and there was a black shadow staring at me from just behind the bathroom door. I could tell it was there, even though I couldn't say what it was. This time, the episode seemed worse, somehow. It was like someone was pinning me down to my bed, and all I could do was watch as the shadow slowly came out of, and all I could do is watch as the shadow slowly came out from behind the door and slid along the wall towards me. I croaked out the only thing that came to me. In the name of Jesus, I command you to leave. Then it stopped and slid backwards to the bathroom door before disappearing behind it. I lay there for a while, still not able to move, with my heart pounding in my chest. As soon as I was able to move again, I quickly shut and locked the bathroom door. And I left it like that until late in the afternoon the following day. To clear up some things about what happened, I have been a devout Christian most of my adult life, and I grew up being taught that nothing evil can stay when you've told it to leave in the name of Jesus. I'm also a hardcore skeptic when it comes to the paranormal. Needless to say, I am less of a skeptic now. The reason why I phrased this experience in the way that I did is because I'm still not sure if what I saw was some kind of demon or evil spirit. All I know is that I didn't know what it was, and that this is one of two times among all my sleep paralysis episodes when I was certain I ran into something that wasn't human. This last experience actually takes place before most of the other times I've mentioned before in this video. I put this one at the end because I'm having a hard time explaining this one. It's one of the few times in my life I've been genuinely horrified. Also, as I've grown older, I've learned that I'm not the only person who has seen something like what I saw in this experience. This happened when I was probably about 15 or 16. And since I was young and a stupid kid, I found myself stuck in a toxic relationship like some of us do from time to time. However, when this took place, I was getting out of said relationship and was finally recovering. I'm not sure what triggered the sleep paralysis this time, although I'm pretty sure it wasn't me that caused it. The day that it happened, I felt like I was taking big steps in the right direction for my life, although I can't remember exactly what those steps were. The point is, I went to bed feeling happy and positive about my life and where it was going, which I think is what makes this particular attack stick out to me more than most. I slept well for the first few hours, and then it hit me. Without warning, I felt this sense of panic. I couldn't move at all, and I could sense something was in my room with me. I used all my strength to quickly grab anything that would protect me in some way. And since I was raised in a Christian home, I grabbed my scriptures. That was when I heard it. A deep, hollow-sounding voice, which seemed to echo in my head.
You really think those will protect you?
I didn't see who or what had said that. In fact, I wasn't sure if I heard it at all. Then I saw it. A large, black shadow slowly appeared from the darkness around me. It looked kind of like a man, only much, much larger. The only thing I remember distinctly is that he was wearing one of those stubby bowler hats you see in the old gangster movies. I had no idea what was going on, so I did the only thing I knew how to do. So I shut my eyes and prayed the shadow would go away. He stayed there for what felt like an hour, though it couldn't have been more than a minute or two, and then he was gone. I felt this heavy energy leave the room, and when I opened my eyes, the room was visibly brighter. As I've gotten older, I've stumbled across other stories of people running into a similar entity, someone they call the Hatman. A lot of those stories seem to end badly when I read them, and I don't know why mine didn't, but I'm grateful that I survived so I could talk about it. To be honest, at the end of the day, I'm not 100% sure how much of what I experienced happened in real life and how much was just in my head. I don't know what any of these things were, but I know what I saw.